सहनावत् सहनौ भुनक्तु सहवीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः ॐ पूर्णमदः पूर्णमिदं पूर्णात् पूर्णमुदच्यते पूर्णस्य पूर्णमादाय पूर्णमेवावशिष्यते ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः ॐ आप्यायन्तु ममाङ्गानि वाक् प्राणश्चक्षुश्रोत्रमथो बलमिन्द्रियाणि च सर्वाणि सर्वं ब्रह्मोपनिषदं माहं ब्रह्म निराकुर्यां मा ब्रह्म निराकरोद् अनिराकरणमस्त्वनिराकरणं मे अस्तु तदात्मनि निरतेय उपनिषत्सु धर्मास्ते मयि सन्तु ते मयि सन्तु ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानाम् आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादम् शङ्करं लोकशङ्करं शङ्करं शङ्कराचार्यं केशवं बालरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वन्दे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः ॐ इत्येतदक्षरमुद्गीतमुपासीत ॐमिति ह्युद्गायते तस्योपव्याख्यानम् पेज 321 प्राणो वा आशाया भूयान् तथा वा अरानाभौ समर्पिताः एवम् अस्मिन् प्राणे सर्वं समर्पितम् प्राणः प्राणेन याति प्राणः प्राणं ददाति प्राणाय ददाति प्राणोः पिता प्राणो माता प्राणो भ्राता प्राणस्वसा प्राण आचार्यः प्राणो ब्राह्मणः प्राणो वै आशायः भूयान् प्राणः दि वैटल् फोर्स् विच् कीप्स् दिस् इण्डिविजुवल् आल्सो अलैव् कान्शियस् अण्ड् डैनमिक् एण्ड् which keeps also the entire universe in motion, keeps the universe dynamic, that is the prana. It has two expressions, vyashti and samashti, at the individual level, at the same time at the cosmic level. See, if you look at footnote number 1 on that page, atra prana asayaha bhyayuktaha prana समष्टि हिरण्यगर्भोपि भवति So prana is greater than asha or the hope. So the tika, the footnote says about prana means samashti. So not only vyashti at the individual level, samashti hiranyagarbha bhavati, is also hiranyagarbha, the cosmic vital force. On what basis do you say that? That upasanasya anyatra bahudha bahusha shrutehe. Because anyatra, elsewhere in the shruti, we find upasanam, the meditation upon Hiranyagarbha, the cosmic prana, that meditation we find in many places. Here also, it is the upasana, a meditation upon prana is prescribed. Therefore, prana here also can mean Hiranyagarbha, the cosmic prana. Vyashti rupena jivopadhi samashti rupena brahmopasana vishayah. Same prana in its individual expression is jivopadhi, the limiting adjunct of the jiva, the vesha, the costume of jiva. At the individual level, prana is the upadhi, the costume for the jiva, for the consciousness to manifest, to express itself. Samashti upena brahma upasana vishaya. As Hiranyagarbha becomes the object of meditation as Brahman. On what basis do you say? Aranabhi drishtantena sarva samarpana upapattehe. So here it is not specifically stated prana upasvedi, asam upasvedi. It's where it's all stated. But prana upasva is not stated here. It can be so understood that prana also is the object of meditation. Why? Aranabhi drishtantena sarva samarpana upapatte. Aranabhi drishtantena, by the illustration of the spokes and the hub. How the spokes are all fixed on the hub, all inserted in the hub. How the hub sustains all the spokes, so also the entire creation is inserted, fixed in prana, in Hiranyagarbha. Just as hub gives the motion, the dynamism to the wheel, so also the prana gives motion, dynamism to the entire universe. In that sense, drishtanta is given. Meaning that we don't need to imagine some kind of wheel in the spokes and stuff like that. Araha iva. So drishtanta is how the hub imparts motion and dynamism to the wheel. That's important. Now we may remember that the hub is in the center and the wheel is in the periphery. So unless something connects the two, it is not possible to transmit the motion of the hub. So motion of cannot be transmitted to the rim unless something connects them. So important thing is that the motion of the hub is transmitted to the rim. So the rim rotates is because of hub. Similarly, we see the whole universe rotating in motion. It's dynamic. And that way it is compared to a wheel or a rim of a wheel. And just as a rim gets its motion and dynamism from the hub, so also prana is in the place of hub. It is only an illustration. We need not imagine universe as a wheel, etc. But then, just as hub imparts emotion, so also that the universe is in motion, is dynamic, shows that there is something that imparts motion to that. Something that makes it dynamic. And that is the prana, that's the cosmic vital force. That is why almost next to Brahman, prana is the most important, essentially. Next to Brahman, more or less you can say. The way it is closest to Brahman, therefore, the Brahman can be compared to the axle. Even the hub also receives this motion from the axle ultimately. So ultimately even prana also receives this motion, dynamism, its existence from Brahman, no doubt about that. But just as hub is closest to the axle, so the prana is closest to Brahman. And just as everything is fixed into Brahman, really speaking, so also everything is fixed into prana. In that sense, prana is similar to Brahman. So ara ara nabhi drishtantena sarva samarpana upapattehe. So really Brahmani dasti bhati priyam. Universe is nama rupa. All names and forms are fixed into Brahman. They have their basis in Brahman. Really they are superimposed upon Brahman. But the idea is that they cannot be without Brahman. And so also we find the whole universe derives its dynamism, its motion from prana, from Hiranyagarbha. Without Hiranyagarbha this could not be. Therefore, Hiranyagarbha is like Brahman. In other words, everything is fixed in that, supported by that, inserted in that. So this is a Vedantic interpretation of prana. This is stated to contrast it with what other people think. Ramanuji yastu pranam jivaiti vadanti. So people ask, Swamiji, same Upanishads are there. How come different acharyas have different interpretations? How do you derive the non-duality and then the qualified non-duality and everything you find from the same Upanishads? And so, because Upanishads lend themselves to those kind of interpretations, so those who are very generous minded, they see that as a glory of the Upanishads. We see them as the fault of the other acharyas, you know. How we see those people, you know, they don't know how to understand this. That's one way. Or it is the glory of the Upanishads. So they are very broad-minded. They respect other acharyas also. In their contempt, what happens is, just because a mango is spoiled in one corner, you throw the whole mango because it is rotten. Similarly, just because these acharyas say something that we don't approve of, we throw them away completely. Whether it's Buddha, whoever it is, all thrown away. But other people are not like that. They look at the whole thing, you know, and what contribution they have made to the whole Indian culture. Very important contributions. So, looking at the greatness of their contribution, those differences to them are minor. To us, the difference is a major, contribution is minor. To them, the contribution is major, differences are minor. Anyway, it's all viewpoint, you know. But still, we have to understand where the differences are. And so that part should also be clear. Not that everything is the same and whatever. But just because everything is not the same, nothing is right also is not right. You see, that's what I'm saying. Ramanuja yastu, the followers of Ramanuja, what do they say? Prana jiva iti vadanti. They say this prana is jiva. So what prana here means jivatma. Why is it so? Why do they say that? Tasya, no, kevalasya, tasya jadatvena. Kevalastasasya, prana on its own is only air. And there is jadam, inert, unconscious, insentient. Himsa pravyukta doshasya. But this, the passage says, next passage says, so this passage says, prana is father, prana is mother, prana is brother, prana is sister, prana is acharya, prana is brahmana. The next passage says, therefore, if you disrespect your father, If it is something which is improper, then you are as good as. So this is the culture. Just saying something disrespectful to an elder is like destroying him, killing him. So when you say something disrespectful to your father, to your mother, to your brother, to your sister, to your teacher, to your brahmana, it is as good as carrying out himsa, as good as killing them. Meaning that you are committing an offense in the form of himsa or violence. So, this passage said, prana is mother, prana is father, prana is brother, prana is sister. Next passage says, if you insult your father, if you insult your mother, if you insult your brother, etc., then you are committing a crime. But father is prana. That if you insult prana, you know, in the form of father, in the form of mother, in the form of brother, then you are committing a crime. But how can you hurt prana? Prana is jada. So a jada thing cannot be hurt. You cannot hurt this table because it is insentient. It is no emotions, no feelings. So this section says that insulting prana is committing a crime in terms of hurting or carrying out violence. That could not be unless prana was a live thing. So therefore prana must be something that is conscious, so it is jiva. Because when you insult jiva, then of course he is carrying out violence. So therefore from the force arthapatti, that this could not be, insulting prana would not be violence unless prana was a alive sentient entity. Therefore they say prana is jiva. So kevalasya tasya jadatvena himsa prayukta dosasya matruhasi tyadi. Next one says matruhasi. Hey, you are a destroyer, you are a killer of a mother, killer of a father. This is a culture. Today, children just say, with no compunction at all, my father is like this and my mother is like that. They quietly say that. Maybe we may have said, I don't remember, but anyway. So to say something belittling the elders is nothing. In those days, belittling the elder, even brother and sister also, was an offense. Invite a lot of papa. Obviously, the consequence is the pay suffering. Chalo, but then, so matruvasi ityadi shuti uktasya ananvayad. So if prana were not jiva, then anvayad, the compatibility would not be with this passage and next passage. By inserting prana, you are hurting prana, you are hurting your mother, then prana must be a live entity. Therefore, prana means jiva. Then only hurting prana is equal to hurting a person. So then prana cannot be simply this air. It must be jivatma. Iti ahu. That is their justification for interpreting prana as jiva. Tanna, but Vedanta says, no, that cannot be. Because you have to look at other contexts also. If you take these two passages, yeah, that sounds reasonable. But you have to look at the entire section and connect it with the prana, else, you know, other aspect, other shrutis also. Pranasya, samashti rupasya, hiranyagarbhasya, upasatvat. The reason why prana is described in this manner here, that the whole universe is fixed in prana, is to glorify prana, is to extol prana, is to praise prana. Why? Because prana is presented as the object of meditation. even though it is not clearly stated, it is presented as object of meditation. Meditate upon prana as Brahman. Vyashte tad abheda. The thing is, so far the context is essentially vyashti. So far the context is individual. When you say that Naman, Vak and Manahan, Sankalpa, all of these basically at the individual level, you know, Vyashti level. So here, how do you, Vedantin, how do you suddenly interpret Prana Hiranyagarbha? So this is Pranasya Samashti Rupasya Hiranyagarbhasya Upasatva. So when it is said, so Asam Upasva, Sankalpa Upasva, that should be all at Samashti level only, because only Samashti Sankalpa, Samashti Mana can alone be meditated upon as Brahman, and so also Prana, Samashti Prana can alone qualify to be meditated upon as Brahman, not individual Prana. Then, but here the context is Vyashti, Vyashte Tadabhedat. Because we do not see difference between Vyashti Prana and Samashti Prana. Basically, it is Prana Tattva is the same. Vyashti and Samashti is only different in the dimension, but as far as substance is concerned, we don't see them as different. How about Himsa? Himsa tu Suddhe Jevena Sambadhyade. In fact, you cannot hurt Shuddha Jiva, you cannot hurt Atma. So now your point is that because hurting Prana is hurting the Atma, therefore Prana must be Atma. So you cannot hurt Atma anyway. Himsa tu Shuddha Jiva, meaning Atmani, or consciousness, you cannot hurt. So hurting is your reason for interpreting Prana as Jiva. That hurting doesn't apply in primary sense anyway. Apitu tadupadu prana eva. What can you hurt? You can hurt the body. You can hurt the prana. You can hurt the upadhi. You can never hurt the atma. That fellow feels hurt. No, that's a different matter. What happens is, you also think that you are hurting the atma or hurting the body or prana. And that person also thinks that he is hurt when his prana, his body or prana is hurt. In reality, no, you cannot hurt the Atma, nor can that fellow feel hurt if he knew that he was Atma. Apitu tadupado prana eva. Himsa can be only at the level of upadhi, it cannot be at the level of consciousness. Tatah jiva himsa api prana himsa ameva pariyavasyade. Even when you say jiva himsa, you kill a cow, you kill an animal, you hurt a human being, ultimately it amounts to saying that you're hurting prana, because atma is beyond any hurt. Prapta aprapta viveka. If you don't have viveka, you feel that you're hurting atma. If you're viveka, then you know that you're hurting prana. Atah bhashyaritya pranapadasya mukhya pranaparatvepi na dosha. Therefore, bhashyaritya, as interpreted by bhashyakara, our bhashyakara, they're all bhashyakaras. So sutra bhashyakara depends upon who is deciding that mandavars. And so, Narayana Samarambham, Ramananda, Ramananda, what is it? Ramananda, Sri Ramananda Madhyama, you know, Sri Ramananda Madhyama. No, Sadashiva Samarambham, Narayana Samarambham. Vande Guru Parampara. So, Atta Bhashya means Sankara Bhashya Ritya, the way Bhashyakara here is interpreted. Pranapadasya mukhya pranaparatvevi na dosha. So as Bhashyakara is interpreted, even prana is interpreted as prana. मुख्य प्राण वाइटल एयर व्यष्टि एंड समष्टि न दोष है देन ऑल्सो स्क्वायर्ड ऑल एयर बिकॉज देन ऑल्सो देर इज कंसिस्टेंसी बिटवीन द टू पैसेजेस सी देर कंसर्न वॉज दैट इफ प्राण इज इंटरप्रेटेड वाइटल एयर देन देर विल नॉट बी कंसिस्टेंसी बिटवीन दिस पैसेज एंड नेक्स्ट पैसेज वी से दैट ultimate himsa can be only carried out at the level of prana, never the level of atma. Therefore, even if prana is interpreted as vital air, there is still consistency between what this passage says and the next passage says. Ramanujiyastu, but the followers of Ramana, because Ramanujacharya, I think, has not written Bhashya on the Upanishads, that's my recollection. But his followers would have written based on the principle of sage Ramanuja. Ramanujastu jiva apekshayapi bhumnaha. There is another reason why they interpret word prana as jiva. But if you see that whole series, the way the succession goes, each following one is superior to the previous one. So vak is superior to nama, mana is superior to vak, sankalpa superior to mana. Like that it goes all the way to bhuman or brahma. So now brahman is superior to jiva, isn't it? But we do not find that. This prana will go to, what is it, sukham I think. Prana is goes to sukham. Satyam. Satyam goes to Jnanam goes to Mananam, Mananam goes to Shravanam, Shravanam goes to Kriya, ultimately goes to Satyam. And Satyam goes to Bhuma. That's the sequence here. So, Bhuma is presented as superior to all these other things, but not superior to Jiva. So that should have been logically stated by the Upanishad. Then you come all the way up to Jiva and then Brahman is superior to Jiva. This is what Upanishad should have stated, really. But Upanishad not stated. Therefore, Ramanujacharya, they say that if prana is interpreted as Jiva, then Bhuman is superior to prana. Therefore, Bhuman becomes superior to Jiva. Then Jiva also gets included in that series, then alone the description is complete, otherwise it is not complete. Jiva apekshayapi bhumnaha utkarsha anutte. That bhuma is not presented as utkrishta, meaning superior to Jiva, which Upanishad should have stated in a logical sequence. Therefore we say that by prana we should mean Jiva, and therefore, that logical presentation would be there. So, Utkarsha Anukti Pariharaya. Because Utkarsha Anukti Upanishad does not say the superior to Bhuman with reference to Jiva or Atma. And that seems to me like a defect. Pariharaya. Therefore, to avoid that fault, that we say that's other reason why prana should here mean jiva, then bhuman is automatically presented as superior to jiva, then that fault will not be there in that presentation. Iti tatha vadanti tat pakshe, then the Vedanta insists tat pakshe jiva se, then when you say pranam brahma iti upasva, may you meditate upon prana as Brahma. You know what it means? May you meditate upon jiva as Brahman. Tat pakshe jivasya brahmatvena upasanam vidayam. Even though in so many words the Upanishad prescribes the meditation on prana, if prana is interpreted as jiva, it would amount to saying that may you meditate upon jiva as Brahman. Tatra upascha upasakayo abhedat. But we say that jiva is Brahman. So upascha is Brahman, upasaka is jiva, abhedat upasana anupattehi. You cannot meditate upon yourself. Meditation is always upon something other than you and something superior to you. But we say that Jiva and Brahman are identical. So how can Jiva meditate upon Brahman? It amounts to saying you are meditating upon your own self. That doesn't make sense, because in meditation there must necessarily be a duality between the meditator and what is meditated upon. Upasana, bhakti should necessarily involve the duality between bhakta and Bhagavan, between devotee and Bhagavan. But Vedanta says the devotee is Bhagavan. Therefore, that meditation will not really make sense. Anupatti, it would have been logical or tenable. But they say that, look, Aham Brahmasmi. So this statement, Aham Brahmasmi, is interpreted by Vedanta as a statement revealing the identity between Aham and Brahma or Jiva and Brahma. They say, no. Aham Brahmasmi is not a statement of non-duality. Aham Brahmasmi is the statement of meditation. So when the Upanishad says, Tattvamasi, means may you meditate upon yourself, you are not Brahman, but may you imagine that you are Brahman. So they interpreted Mahavakya as the statements of Upasana. So they interpreted them as Vidhivakya, as understand. Even though there is no vidhi, there is no kriyapada, no verb of injunction, still they say you should imagine a verb of injunction, that all these Mahavakyas are the statements for prescribing meditation upon Brahma. So Aham Brahmasmi, according to them, he prescribes only that we meditate upon Aham, Ahangra Upasana, as Brahman. Abhiche Aham Brahma iti abheda upasanam atra vidhiyate iti uktau, that's what they say. So Jiva Brahma are not identical. It's abheda upasana is there. So then the fault that you say, that prana is Jiva, that fault will not arise, not Jiva. Iti uktau bhavan mate, if you say that Jiva is not really Brahman, but Upanishad always prescribes meditation upon Jiva as Brahman, if this is what you have to say, then Atmeti tu upagacchati grahayanti chayati sutrat. Brahma Sutra says Atma iti tu upagacchanti. See, the state upagacchanti statement of Upanishads. Atma iti upagacchanti, the statements of Upanishads, in fact, they all acknowledge or arrive at Atma being Brahman. Sutra says that the tatparya of all the Upanishad statements is to present Atma as Brahman. Grahayanti cha tattvamasi, it tells you also to know Atma as Brahman. So Jabal Upanishad says, Tvam va aham asmi bhagavah devate aham vai tvam asi. Hey devata, tvam vai aham asmi, you are I, aham vai tvam asi, I am you. So this statement very clearly say that aham and you, the devata, are one. So they acknowledge the oneness between the Jiva and Ishvara, or the devotee and God. So not only they acknowledge that, they say also tattvamasi grahayanti, they make you accept it, make you grasp it, make you understand it. It is sutra. So we take that sutra into account, which sutra saying that Upanishads present the identity between Jiva and Brahma. Aham Brahma iti upasanasyeva moksha sadhanatvat. So by that sutra, Aham Brahma, that knowledge is the means of moksha. According to you, that upasana is the means of moksha. Alright, according to you, that is a state of upasana. Then, tasya cha prana vakya deva siddhe, then that when it's prano, pranam brahma di upasva, then that is already covered here, you need not go further. Bhuma upadesha vyarthasyaat, then subsequently that bhuma is brahman, you are brahman, that upadesha would be meaningless because already this passage itself says that prana is brahman. Idi vivechaniyam, so that's how the vivechana is carried out by the footnote kar here, tippani kar. Going to next passage. Yattu pranoha pita, pranomata ityadu, pranasya, jadasya, pitrutva anupattehi. So Upanishad says, so pranoha pita, pranomata, pranobhrata, prana is father, prana is mother, prana is brother. How can Upanishad say? If prana were merely air, vital air, how can it be father and mother? So prana being jada cannot be called pita and mata and bhrata. Then you know what you have to say? Pitru sharirasthatvena gauna kalpanacha guru bhudayate. So then they will argue that you are saying that in gauna, in a secondary sense, prana is pita and mata. Because what you call pita is this body. And prana being in this body, therefore by body in fact is implied the prana within the body. Then you have to go so many steps. Father is the name of this body. So prana hai pita. If prana is father, then body should be by lakshana vritti interpreted as prana. So gauna kalpana cha guru bhuta. Guru means what? It's a very lengthy way of arriving at the ultimate conclusion. Deva prana means prana itself. By prana is meant pita. Then you don't have to go two steps. In one step alone, the prana is pita. That's their argument. Tanna. Then Vedanta says, no, that's not so. Prana shabdasya jiva paratve lakshana kalpanaya hayavapi avashyakatva. We say that when the prana is jiva, already lakshana vritti you accepted. Because prana literally means what is lakshana vritti? When vachyartha does not fit, then you go for lakshyartha. So vachyartha prana is only vital air. So when you interpret prana, you already lakshana vritti, you have accepted. So you are not much different from us. Lakshana kalpanaya avashyakatvat. So what's it then? Alright, both of us have to resort to lakshana. Then do we have some advantage? Asmakam tu pranasya jivupaditvat jivasya se shuddhatvat jive praoktam pitrutvadikam praneva parivasyati iti. Mukhyameva pitrutvadikam iti visheshaha. Asmakam tu for us pranasya jivupaditvat. Prana is the upadhi or vesha of the atma. Jivasya shuddhatva, jivatma is sachidananda shuddha. Prana is the upadhi or vesha of the jiva. Jive proktam pitrutvadikam, therefore the pita, mata, etc. applies to jiva all right. But prana being the upadhi of the jiva, in fact, ultimately it amounts to saying that prana alone is father, because atma is not father, mother. So jivasya shuddhatva. Nobody can say atma is father and atma is mother. Jiva is Satchidananda, can't be father and mother. So who can be father? Only the Vesha is father and mother. You know, this is a very wealthy person. You can't call him beggar. He is a multi-millionaire. So when you call him beggar, in as much as the actor cannot be beggar, therefore, that beggar only rests only in this costume. So similarly, Jivatma being Satchidananda cannot be prana anyway. Therefore, when Upanishad says pita prana, mata prana, then that verb, I mean, so But after that, Pita and Mata cannot apply to Atma, only apply to Prana. So that's the advantage in our interpretation. So Mukhyameva Pitrutvadikam. Mukhya beggar is only costume. So Mukhya Prana, Mukhya Pita is only Prana. Mukhya Mata is Atma, is not Pita and Mata in the primary sense. The Upadhi alone is Pita and Mata in the primary sense. Therefore, Prana is Upadhi. Therefore, in primary sense, Prana is Pita and Mata. According to you, it is in secondary sense. But he will say, but what about Jiva? Upanishad doesn't say that Brahman is superior to Jiva. Then what about that step is missing? Jiva anuktistu na doshah. We say that there is not a defect. Brahma ukteva tad abhedat tad ukteh. We say that when you say Brahman, Atma is already stated, because Brahman and Atma are one. Therefore, you need not say separately about Atma. Just to give a taste of, you know, the kind of discussion that they have. Anyway, so, eva asmin prana sarvam samrapitam. So just as the spokes are fixed onto the hub, so also the entire universe is fixed into prana, which is in the place of the hub. Prana pranayati. Prana is the self of all. Prana pranayati. So when the prana moves, then I move. Then I am prana, prana moves. Bhashyakara says prana moves on its own without the help of anything else. So one who moves also is prana, and movement also is prana. Prana pranam dadati. When you give something to somebody else, the giver also is prana, and the one to whom it is given prana also is prana. The receiver also is prana. And what is given also is prana. Pranaya dadati, to whom it is given also is prana. What is given also is prana. The one who gives also is prana. Giving also is prana. Deva prana is the self of all. Prana is everything. Deva prana is pita and mata and bhrata and swasa and asari and brahma. Therefore, now going to the next passage in the page 323. Bhashyakara says, so the Tika says, Anandagiri says, prasiddhi anatikramaniya iti shankate. Prasiddhi, nobody says prana is father and prana is mother. And Upanishad says, it's not known to anybody, this is not a common usage, that prana is father and prana is mother. So how to transgress? The prasiddhi means the commonly understood meaning. Father, nobody calls prana father. Father is father. So prasiddhi anatikramaniya. The point is that primarily the word must be used only in the commonly understood meaning. Only when that is not feasible, then only you adopt the implied meaning. So what's the reason why? So Bhashyakara is the katham. Katham pitradi shabdanam prasiddhathar sargena pranamishyatvam iti. Sorry. Prasiddhartho-tsargena. Because my thing is here, you know, that thing. Again, katham pitradi-sabdana prasiddhartho-tsargena pranamishyatvam iti. So, pranamapita, prana mata, prana bhata. What does Upanishad say? Prana is father, prana is mother, prana is brother. Prasiddhata utsargena. How Upanishad has given up the prasiddhartha, the commonly understood meaning of father and mother, And why did Upanishad say prana is father? Something that nobody knows. Oh, nobody knows means the word, the prana, the father, mother, they are never used in the sense of prana. All used for father and mother are father and mother. Not prana is not called father and mother. So prasiddhatha utsargena prana vishetvam. So why is father, word father is equated to prana? Where? Father is father, mother is mother. Father is not mother, mother is not brother, brother is not sister. Your father also is prana, mother also is prana, brother also is prana. So commonly understood meaning of the word father, mother, brother are all discarded here or given up here. And Shruti is using the word, using the words father, mother in a sense different from what is commonly used. Katham, why is it so? So that question should arise. So Anandagiri says, Anva vitarikabhyam pitradi shabdanam prana vishayatvat na prasiddhe ullanganam ityaha. Anvaya vitirika abhyam. Anvaya, agreement. Vitirika, disagreement. Anvaya vitirika abhyam. By the method of anvaya and vitirika, if you really see who is the father in the primary sense and who is the real father, who is the real mother. If you really want to understand, when we say father and mother, we may not have given much thought to whom we are calling father and mother. But when we really analyze, then in what sense are we using the word father and mother? We will then understand that it is prana alone that is called father and mother, even in the common usage. Commonly also, people are calling prana alone as father and mother. Anvaya vitireka, what is anvaya? As long as prana is here, so long you call him father. When prana is not there, nobody calls him father. Prana is there, call him mother, brother, sister. When prana departs, nobody calls that upadhi mother. So, even you also are calling whom? Who? Why are you calling father? Prana alone. So, anvaya vitireka abhyam. Pitradi shabdanam prana vishayatvat. So by the method anvaya vitireka, we find that pitru matru, so father, mother, these words apply to prana only, even in the common usage. People also use these words in the sense of prana. Itya uchyate, Vashyakara says. Uchyate. So next year, Pariharati. So this objection is refuted. Bhashyakara says, Sati prane pitradishu pitradishabda prayogat tat utkrantau cha prayoga abhavat. Sati prane pitradishu pitradishabda prayogat. Only when, only as long as prana is there in his body, then alone that person is referred to as father and mother. Tad utkrantau, when prana departs, no more that entity is called father or mother, unfortunately, whatever, prayoga bhavat. Even if you say out of emotion, sentiment, still you don't mean it, you know. Because that entity no more serves the purpose of father and mother. Out of sentiments of my father and mother, it's okay. But in reality, you also know that there is no father and mother in that. So, anvivedireka eva prasna purvakam prakatayati. Anvaya vidireka alone is explained as preceded by a question, katham iti. Vasekara says, katham tada. ityah. How do you say that a person is called father as long as prana is, and no more called father, etc., when the prana is not? And how do you say that? Upanishad says that. So the next passage says, Sayade pitaram va, mataram va, bhrataram va, swasaram va, acharyam va, brahmanam va, kinchida, bhrushamiva pratyaha, dhiktva astu, iti eva enamahuhu. Pitruhavaitvamasi, Matruhavaitvamasi, Bhratruhavaitvamasi, Swasruhavaitvamasi, Acharyahavaitvamasi, Brahmanahavaitvamasi. Anvaya. So, the pitaramva, mataramva, bhataramva, father, mother, brother, sister, elder brother, sister, imagine. Acharyamva, the teacher, brahmanamva, a brahmana, good, bad, indifferent, elder, what of brahmana is brahmana. So, that's the kind of respect brahmanas enjoy in this culture. Kinchit bhrushamiva pratyaha, to anybody. Bhrusham, you are improper. Whenever you address any of these persons in an improper manner, then immediately people sending around, they say, Dhitva, shame on you. This is how you are talking to your father. That's how you talk to your mother. That's not the way. Shame on you. Dhitva, fie on you. That's what they say. Then how do they say? Pitruhavaitvamasi. Hey, you are a killer of your father. You killed your father. You hurt your father. Destroyed your father. Meaning, you, even if you have not destroyed the person, by using this word, you, this, that, you know, people use that. Sometimes a lot of anger, sometimes a lot of fun also. These days you make fun of your parents or fun of anybody. And use whatever word that occurs to you. Out of fun, out of looseness, out of anger. So, of course, often children have anger towards father and mother. But if I remember, we used to keep, I don't remember if I had anger for father or mother. But even if somebody had, you always kept it to yourself. Here, I hate you, mom. You are like this and you are this. Right away, they express their feelings in very harsh words. So we never did this to our parents. When we go to United States, our children do that to us. Understand, there is a problem there. This poor generation, in between generation, this generation, the first generation immigrants who were raised in India in a certain way and who were raised with revering their parents and elders, and this is, you know, so that's our culture. That's not the culture in the West. There's no reverence there. So fathers are what? Swamis are what? You know? So for anybody to be respected by me, he must prove that he is respectable. This way is not proving. See the way he behaves. So father must prove himself respectable to be respected by the child. He doesn't get respect by virtue of being father. Here he did. Here Swami gets respect by virtue of being Swami. Not there. So this person who was raised revering his father and mother and elders expects naturally a similar kind of treatment from his children when he doesn't get that. They hurt, really. They are getting hurt. This generation is very much hurt. But anyway, so this is a Vedic culture. then also somebody out of anger may have said it. That is why when Arjuna had to fulfill his vow of killing whoever insults my Gandiva, I'll kill him. And unfortunately, Yudhishthira did that in a given situation. And Arjuna says, I have to fulfill my vow. He was ready to kill. So Lord Krishna says, look, killing can be two ways. So by words also you can kill a person. A person who should be revered, if you insult him openly, as good as is, so nishastra vadaha. So you can kill a person without weapons also. Anyway, so therefore insulting is equated to vadha or killing. Meaning that you will incur that much sin. By insulting somebody, some revered person, that sin which you will incur by killing that person. So they will say, you are killer of a father, call it patricide, killer of a mother, matruha vaitvasi, you are a matricide, killer of your homicide. Side means killer. Patri means that French word. Patricide, matricide, killer of the father, killer of mother. Bratruha vaitvasi, fratricide, you are killer of a fraternity, your brother. Sasruha, you are killer of a sister. Acharya, killer of a teacher. Brahmana havai tomasi, killer of Brahmana, that's what they will say. Meaning that you kill them. Because prana is there, therefore when you treat that person like this, it is as good as killing the person. Meaning his father, because he is alive, therefore he is called father, she is called mother, etc. So Bhashyakara explains that. सयह कश्चित् पित्रादीनां अन्यतमं यदि तं भृशमिव तत् अननरूपम् इव किञ्चित् वचनं त्वं कारादियुक्तं प्रत्याह तदा एनं पार्श्वस्था आहुः विवेकिनः धिक्त्वा अस्तु दिगस्तुत्वान् इत्येवं पितृहावै त्वं पितुः हन्ता इत्यादि सः यः कश्चित् हुएव दट् पर्सन् इस् पित्रादिना अन्यत वन् आफ् दीस् पिता माता भ्राता स्वसा एनीबडी आचार्य ब्राह्मण एनी वन ऑफ देम दे मेंशन हियर यदि तम भृशम इव तत् अनुरूपम इव सो भृशम इव मीन्स व्हाट आउट ऑफ हेस्ट आउट ऑफ एंगर विदाउट थिंकिंग अनुरूपम. When we get excited, then we don't think and we say something out of excitement. Anurupam, improper. What is improper? Tvam karadayuktam, instead of bhavan, you say tvam. You should use bhavan, your good self, you. That's a great insult. So, Bhashyakara, tvam itself is insult. Let alone telling some bad word that is far, far, fast. Even tvam. So, tat anrupayo kinchit vachanam. So therefore in our culture you don't even address an elder person by name, you know. Swamiji you say, etc. You know. So you don't say you came and you went. You don't use those singular words. Tada enam parsasthaha vivekina avu. Then if there are people around him who are wise people, then they say, Dikva, shame on you, fie on you. Digasu Swamitya, that's what they will say. Pitruha Vaitvamasi, you are a killer of a father. Pitramis Pitu Hanta Ityadi, you are a killer of the father. That's what they will say. That's the Anvaya. So Anvaya says, Pitradishu Pranayasati, Pitradishabdaram Prajyamanatvam अन्यथा च अप्रयोज्यमानं तत् इति उच्यते. What of that tat? Anurupaya, where is that tat? So, that's only tat there. So, katham tat ityaha. In what way do you say that as long as prana is there, then there is pita, otherwise not? Katham tat. So, what is tat? Pitradishu pranayasati pitradishabdhanam prayujyamanatvam. In father, mother, etc., as long as prana is there, so long alone, you employ the word father, mother, use the words. Anyatha cha aprayojimanatvam. Prana is not there, you don't call that entity father, mother, etc. So katham tat, how is the anvaya vitareka? That's what he said. Tvam karadi yuktam iti adipadena. So tvam karadi yuktam, tvam kara, etc. What is etc.? Tiraskara, praveda, different kinds of tiraskara, different kind of insult. So you and in different ways of insulting a person, whatever it is. Of either example you or any other expression you use which amounts to insulting. Pitradeshu apriyavadinam prati vivekena dhikkarvasane hetumaha. So people who are around, wise learned people, why do they? So why did they say this to him? Five shame on you. So why did they scold him? Shame on you. Because Pitruha Tunasi Pitruhanta, hey, you killed your father. You know what you have done by insulting, killed your father. That is why they say that. That's the Anvaya. In next passage. Sati prane pitradishu pitradishabdhanam prayojamat anvayam uktva. So this passage number 2 said anvayam, that prana is there, use the word pita is there. So what is vyatireka? Prana is not there, use the word pita is not there. Vyatireka maha atha. Then next passage says atha yadyapi एनान उत्क्रांत प्राणान शूलेन समासं विदिशन्दहे नैव एनं ब्रूयुः पितृहासीदे न मातृहासीदे न भ्रातृहासीदे न स्वश्रुहासीदे नाचार्यः सीदे न ब्राह्मणः सीदे. यद्यपि इवन वेन एनान उत्क्रांत प्राणान, वेन फ्रॉम फादर और मदर फ्रॉम एनी वन ऑफ देम, वेन प्राण हैज डिपार्टेड, देन इवन दिस फेलो मिस्ट्रीट्स दैट एंटिटी. शूलेन समासं यदि संदहेत. Now that body is to be cremated. While cremating, the body is subjected to a lot of rough treatment. He is no more treated respectfully. It's something to be now burnt, that's all. The hand comes out, you put it this way. You know, things they do. So, shulena with a spear. Means with a very sharp piece of wood. They'll do that, all kinds of things. They're professional people, you see. The close family doesn't do that. But there are people, or professional people, who immediately, as soon as death happens, a team comes. In every caste, there are teams that come. And they do those. We don't know, you can't do that also. So then, giving the bath and changing clothes and then trying with that and carrying it and laying down and doing all that things. You watch, but they do all this. So for them it's something to be done, you know. And so that's how very often that body is very roughly treated when it is cremated. So shulena yadyapi shulena samasam. If they sometimes heap one body upon the other and do that, or vyatishandeya, or they separate the limbs, I never seen it, I don't know. But anyway, so then even when he treats that entity like that, They don't say Pitruha, that you are a killer of your father, killer of your mother. They don't say. Because that entity is no more called father or mother. Therefore, in fact, he is hurting. In fact, he is killing physical violence. Even then, they do not say that you are carrying out violence. Because there is no more father or mother. So, Vyatireka. This is only for why prana is called father and mother, Anvaya and Vyatireka. So, Upanishad gives this example. Says Vashyakara. अथ एनान एव उत्क्रांत प्राणान त्यक्त देहान अथ यद्यपि शूलेन समासम समस्य वेदन शम मिसिंग दैट व्यतिशम दहे व्यत्यस्य संदहे एवं अपि अतिक्रूरं कर्म समास व्यत्यासादि प्रकारेण दहन लक्षणं तद्देह संबद्धं एव कुर्वाणं नैवं ब्रूयुः पितृः इत्यादि अथ एनानेव सेम फादर सेम मदर एटसेट्रा एनानेव उत्क्रांत प्राणान व्हेन प्राणा इज डिपार्टेड फ्रॉम दोज वेरी बॉडीज त्यक्त देहान मीनिंग प्राणा इज डिपार्टेड फ्रॉम द बॉडी यद्यपि व्हेन दैट सेम पर्सन द सन और व्हाट एवर शूलेन विद अ स्पियर से शूलेन लास्ट येन सूक्ष्माग्रेण काष्ठेन मृत शरीरम भित्वा दहन्ति तत्सूरम एनीवे वन शार्प पीस ऑफ वुड which appears for, you know, cremating, etc. It's called shulam here. So, samasam, samasa, sankshepaha, heaping them together. Vyati sande, vyatyasya, sandeha, vyatyasana, vivida, kshepaha. They, you know, put them separately. Sandehe, they burn their body. Yopi ati kruram karma. This is the most cruel act that you can perform. समास व्यत्यासादि प्रकारेण दहन लक्षणं अति क्रूरं कर्म सो क्रिमेटिंग दैट बॉडी बाय हीपिंग और बाय सेपरेटिंग सो इवन व्हेन यू परफॉर्म सच एन क्रूअल एक्ट द देह संबद्ध में द वेरी सो कनेक्टेड द वेरी सेम बॉडी विच सिंपली बाय इंसल्टिंग वॉज कॉल्ड द किलर ऑफ फादर मदर नाउ ही इज डूइंग दिस टू द सेम बॉडी Naivam Bruyuhu Pitruha Ityadi. Still the same people don't say, hey, you're killing your father, you're killing your mother. They don't say that. So Sri Dhanagiri, Samasya Punjikritya Vyatyasya Abhavan Vivajya, etc. So heaping or separating. Now Yadyapiti Upakramat Yavapiti Etat Tathapiti Asmanasya Dashtavyam. See, Atha Yadyapi. So Vashyakara says, Atha Enam उत्क्रांत प्राण त्यक्त देह अथ यद्यपि शूलेन समागच्छत एंड इट सेज एवं अपि अतिक्रूरम सो यद् एवं अपि शुड बी तथापि सो तथापि इति अस्मिन् अर्थे द्रष्टव्यं तथापि तदेव अतिक्रूरं कर्म विशिनस्ति वर्ण अतिक्रूरं कर्म समास व्यत्यासादि प्रकरण दहन लक्षणं दैट क्रूअल एक्ट अवयोजनम आदि शब्दार्थ तदेह संबंध में तत्शब्द है क्रूर पित्रादि विषय नॉट क्रूर पित्रादि विषय है मीन क्रूर कर्म पित्रादि विषय है सेम सेम फादर्स बॉडी टुवर्ड्स दिस दिस क्रूर एक्ट इज कैरिड आउट यद्यपि त्यक्त प्राण से अभी देह पिता शब्द इवन दो समटाइम्स इवन फॉर इट इवन दो द बॉडी इज डेड पीपल डू यूज द वर्ड माई फादर माई मदर बट स्टिल तथापि न सो मुख्य इट्स नॉट इन अ प्राइमरी सेंस दैट दे यूज दैट तद विषय क्रूर कर्म अनुष्ठान भी शिष्ट ग्रह अदृष्टा सो विद द सेम बॉडी इवन दो सच क्रूर एक्ट इज परफॉर्म ही इज नॉट कंडेम्ड बाय द पीपल द एल्डर पीपल अराउंड हिम दैट इज व्हाई व्हेन लॉर्ड कृष्णा डिपार्टेड फ्रॉम हियर डिड नॉट इवन लीव हिज बॉडी Lord Krishna departed from this world along with his body. giving the lesson, don't leave your body. Meaning, once you are done, you are settled your account, you are liberated. Don't have any attachment to the body and don't try to make any great effort to continue that body or prolong the life of that body. What's the use of it? Body is body. Lord Krishna, therefore, along with body, he departed. Did not leave his body behind. Otherwise, people will preserve it and do this and so. No, he doesn't want that. So, Ukta Anvayavyatireka Phalam Upasamharati. So, what Anvayavyatireka, what does it mean? Sati is Vashyakara says, no, Tasmadati. Tasmad Anvayavyatireka Bhyan Avagamyate Etata Pitradhyakshopi Prana Eva Iti. Therefore, from this Anvayavyatireka, agreement and disagreement, it is avagamyate. This is what we understand. What the Shruti wants to communicate is pitradhyakshavi pranayava. So pita, mata, bhrata, nothing but prana alone is pita, mata, bhrata in the primary sense. Even though it may not be the current or the popular usage, but even people also by their very behavior say that prana alone is called father and mother, and therefore prana is father. So prana is self of all, in short. Prana is everything. So prana is like Brahman. Therefore prana is to be meditated upon as Brahman. Okay. Om Purnamada Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamada Yapurnamevavashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Shankaram Shankaracharyam Keshavam Badarayanam Sutra Bhashya Krutau Vande Bhagavantau Punah Punah. Ishvaro Gururatmedi Murti Veda Vibhagine Vyomavat Vyapta Dehaya Dakshinamurtaye Namaha. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Hari Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Hari Om.